Today I'll be restoring this Rogue Holland bicycle, manufactured somewhere between the late 80s and the early 90s, so this is roughly a 30-year-old bike. The bike is very rusty from being neglected and left outside for many years, but it's just surface rust. The only thing mechanically wrong with it is the rear brake cable and the lack of oil and grease, plus the white paint is starting to deviate. The first step is to completely disassemble the bicycle. First, I'll take apart the cockpit and throw away the handlebars, which are a bit too rusty to re-chrome. Then it's onto the dynamo-powered front white light, followed by the metal rod assembly that holds the front mudguard attached to the fork, and it will have to be straightened since it's all bent. In order for the stem to come out, a 32mm nut has to be unfastened. Just like the handlebars, the stem is going to be replaced. The headset ball bearings look great and will just be cleaned and relubed. Now the front and then the rear wheel can come out. The removal of the rear fender got a bit tricky. As I was removing it, I stumbled upon a stuck screw, which was already hard to get to with a screwdriver, but then being so rusty, I couldn't even turn it a little bit. Now I'm taking off the rear brake and the plastic sunglasses case, which is broken and a bit impractical, so I won't bother reusing it. Then came off the cranks and the front chainring. The mechanism holding the cranks onto the bottom bracket's axle, in my opinion, is not very practical and useful. In the long run, since the threaded pins are mostly held in place with friction. Oh yeah, and I just grinded off the screw that was stuck from before. After some usage, the pins will wear out and leave you with a loose crank arm that will flop around while you pedal. Then the bottom bracket disassembly started. The bearings seemed nice and well lubed. All the parts look pretty rough. For some reason, the right bearing nut didn't want to come off the axle, so it'll just stay in place. The hardest part of the disassembly was removing the bottom and top bearing cups from the frame, and also the cup on the fork, which holds the fork beauty lid on. Since I'll be replacing the chain, I just cut off the old one. Now I started on the electronics. The front light was easy to disassemble and it will just need a new coat of paint. Now onto the long tedious task of removing all the rust and grime of every single part. Every single nut and washer will need to be restored. As the front light cover, the rear light exterior is getting a new paint job. These wires hold the front and back fenders in place and keep them from rattling around. The wheel rims are so rusty, so the plan is I'll break down both the wheels and swap out the rims for some used ones that were very hard to find. Then I serviced both hubs. Thank you. I cleaned the bearings, then added new grease. You have to make the hubs as tight as possible without compromising the wheel's smoothness and spinning duration. The long paint removal process starts. I decided not to use paint stripper just cuz, so instead I used wire wheels with a drill attachment. I brushed the fork frame and both the fenders until they were all shiny and pure bare metal. While removing the paint, the wires also remove all the rust spots. I also had to change my battery-powered drill for one with a power cord because it has more power and lasts however long I want. I couldn't get some of the paint that was in the corners of the frame. Then I cut off the chain guard mount since I won't be adding a chain guard over the chain. And if I do so, the bike would look way cleaner. That's why I also cut off this mount for an old locking mechanism. Finally, painting. I started with a car primer, of which I sprayed two layers. I decided to paint the bike with a glossy green color. These little scuffs are from grinding off the chain guard mount. Over the paint, I sprayed a coat of lacquer. By this point, I finally got a hold of the chrome rims. Now I need to break down both the wheels to replace their rims. One of the replacement rims already came assembled with an inner tube and a tire. But since I already serviced the hubs on my old wheels, I'll break down the new ones just to get the rims. Since I'll be adding new nipples, I would have had to do it anyways. To true the newly built wheels, I'll be using this other project bike. And just like that, the wheels look as they just came fresh out the factory. I had a few more bits of hardware left to restore. I have to polish every bolt and nut to get them ready for chrome plating. You have might been wondering why I left the copper wires in the frame. I left them so I can use them to help me pass through the new brown ones. Now onto the machining part of this restoration. I have to replace these spring holding nuts. The old ones are made out of aluminum, which breaks easier, so I'll be making the new ones out of stainless steel. On the lathe, I tapped an M6 thread. Then my friend helped me use his milling machine, which we used to cut the slit for the spring that puts the tension on the brakes. Here are all the parts ready to get chrome plated. The company that plated my parts is called Galma, and they offer a wide variety of plating options. Now all the parts are laid out and ready to be assembled. That's it, I'm just gonna assemble the bike.
alone here on my island, floating in the sky. I'm high above the world I used to know, and I'm far from any danger, safe from any failure. Guarded, I found shelter in the storm. I'm hiding in the blue, safe between the clouds. Was a soldier in the legions, fought against the demons, fought against the monsters made of gold. But they stormed across Arcadia, following their nature, washed away the place I once called home. I'm hiding in the blue, safe between the clouds.